Hello on Wednesday the 27th of October. And may the Lord be with you. I'll pray. Lord, you give us life, you give us love, you give us yourself. Help us to give our lives, our love and ourselves to you and to others. Through Christ who died and rose again for us. Amen. Our readings today are from Psalm 13. And Romans chapter 8, verses 26 to 30. I wonder how well we actually know ourselves. I suspect that on a certain level, we know ourselves quite well. But this is probably at a rather superficial level, and is only a small percentage of all that it is possible to know about ourselves. This lack of understanding can mean that on some occasions we behave in what we consider to be an uncharacteristic manner for us, because we're not aware of that part of ourselves. This limited understanding must also create an element of difficulty for us relating to prayer, because if we pray to God, we have a problem focusing on things that we're not aware of, the unforeseen areas. And when we think about it, we want to talk to God about everything. Not only to do with ourselves, but what's going on around. In today's psalm, we find that King David has convinced himself that God has forgotten about him. But then David is viewing matters from a human perspective. But help is at hand, for David and for us. Because God's Holy Spirit is playing an active role in our lives. God knows all about us. After all, he did create us. And he knows the things which we don't know about ourselves. Because God is all-knowing. This knowledge about us means that the Holy Spirit is able to intercede, to pray on our behalf. We may not know our needs, but the Holy Spirit does. And not only this, the Holy Spirit also knows the words to use as he prays on our behalf. I'm now going to pray for our leaders. Gracious Lord, we continue to pray for everyone who is in a position of leadership of any kind. As the weeks go by, the decisions they need to make don't become any easier. We ask that you pour down your wisdom on all leaders, and we particularly ask for wisdom for all of those who are involved in the formation of the autumn financial statement, which we're going to hear this week from the government. And we pray that they follow the wise guidance which you give to them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. For today's prayer points, let's pray for anyone who is struggling to make financial ends meet. Let's pray and give thanks for the organisations which help them. And these include Christians Against Poverty and the Food Bank, and so many other organisations. And let's pray for children who find themselves caught up in poverty through no fault of their own. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. I hope that you continue to have an enjoyable half-term break. And today's blessing. Let the word of the Lord be a light to your path. Peace in your life, and hope for your journey. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with us all today and evermore.